Good afternoon. Welcome to the inaugural concert of our Music and Sanctuary series. I wasn't sure how many people were coming today. I assumed 5 to 10. It's a few more than that. So I must say I'm quite delighted. I must also imagine that Her Majesty has something to do with that. So it's wonderful to celebrate with you this afternoon. Just a few words about our program and how things will unfold. I'm just going to make my remarks now, and I'll cover the whole program just by way of explanation or interpretation, and I hope that some of those words stay with you just as I move from piece to piece. I've selected them all for their particular appropriateness to the occasion. Before I get into the details of the program, though, this series will run every Tuesday until the 20th of December. We'll have a short break, a few weeks, and then we'll resume our concerts on, I believe it's the 6th of January, the beginning of January anyway. And we hope to carry them on right through to the spring. And we have a lot of wonderful artists that have been really excited about playing here and being part of the return of live music to our city and to our downtown. St. Andrews is blessed with a wonderful pipe organ, which will be featured widely in the series, but not exclusively. So we'll have artists from a number of different disciplines presenting quite a variety of music, contemporary, classical, traditional, and inventive, I guess would be the best way to describe it. So thank you for being part of all of this today. Following the concert, we'll have also our inaugural soup lunch. The soup today is a late summer tomato and basil, and it comes right out of the Buckingham Palace cookbook. So Her Majesty will have doubtless eaten this at least once. And I really want to thank Janet and John Vanagon and Patricia Wilson for all of they've done to support the concert in that way and provide for the soup. We didn't know how many portions to prepare. So in one sense, I hope you're not all coming for soup, but I hope that a lot of you are as well. So whether you are or aren't, you would be able to find it in theory through this exit sign, and you'll move into the first hall that you see, Fergus Grant Hall, and you turn right and go right to the end of the hallway and you'll see Curry Hall, and that's where the soup will be served. We're asking for a donation of $5 for the soup. The concerts, we're not asking for a donation, but you are certainly encouraged, I guess one could say, to offer us one. You can put it in either of these collection plates that you see there, and all of these offerings, if you will go to compensate the artists or defray the concert series expenses in one way or another. Next week's concert will be played by my very esteemed colleague, Sean Potter, who is the organist of First Baptist Church, corner of Laurier and Elgin, one of Canada's foremost young organists, and he will be presenting a program of German Baroque works of composers who lived before the time of Bach. So it's a wonderful opportunity to hear some of that music next Wednesday. Now to today's concert. So as we know, Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II was laid to rest yesterday at St. George's Chapel, Windsor Castle, and also her funeral service was held at Westminster Abbey. There was also a commemorative service here at Christ Church Cathedral. Several other places around the world also commemorated Her Majesty's passing yesterday, including at Christ Church Cathedral Victoria, a place where I used to hang out quite a bit back in the day. They had a beautiful service that's available online, and St. James Cathedral Toronto is doing a service of memorial this afternoon. All of those services are available on YouTube or through some other platform, and I respect very much the efforts of all of those places and the musicians therein to provide appropriately for Her Majesty's memorial. One of the things that didn't happen yesterday in the memorial service in Ottawa was the singing of the royal anthem. So we're going to make up for that today by beginning the concert by singing not one verse but two of God Save the King. And after I've played a short fanfare by Sir Arthur Bliss, which is often partnered with this anthem, I invite you to stand and sing it with good courage, and then the rest of the concert will proceed. The first work on the concert is the only non-British work there. It's by Johann Sebastian Bach, and you might find that a strange addition to a concert of royal music. But the tradition has been, on many of these solemn occasions, to play the works of Bach. This Fantasia in C minor was played by my colleague Peter Holder, who is the assistant director of music at Westminster Abbey, at the conclusion of yesterday's service there. Indeed, another piece by Bach, his C minor prelude and fugue, was played by Luke Bond at St. George's Chapel, Windsor. I thought that was particularly affecting because Luke also played that for Prince Philip's funeral. This particular C minor Fantasia is a beautiful and majestic piece. When I was learning it about 45 years ago or so, I remember my teacher telling me at the time that it was played at John F. Kennedy's funeral in Washington National Cathedral. So great is its solemnity. So I hope that you will agree. Moving from there, the first of three pieces on the program today by the great British master, Sir Edward Elgar. Sir Edward was always, perhaps in the earlier part of his career, kind of left out of things a little bit because most of the leading British composers of the day were either from the Church of England or from the Methodist tradition. Elgar, of course, was a Catholic. His Enigma variations, composed at the end of the 19th century, were really the first works that vaunted him to the forefront of popularity. And the third variation is called Nimrod. It was played at the commemorative service here yesterday by an excellent violinist. And this arrangement for the organ is mine. It's often performed on the organ. Sir Charles Hubert Hastings Parry, he of the great coronation anthem, I Was Glad, was also the founder of the Royal College of Music, a place where I hung my hat for a couple of years way back when, and this is his fantasy chorale on O God, Our Help in Ages Past. Moving from there back to Sir Edward, we have his fourth Pomp and Circumstance March. Just for curiosity once, I looked up what pomp and circumstance means in the musical sense, and it was, the first word I saw was ostentatious. And I had never actually associated that quite with the pomp and circumstance marches. Of course, the first one is the famous Land of Hope and Glory. Arguably, the fourth one is the second most popular. And although the words to the main theme have not, to my knowledge, been put to, sorry, the music of the main theme has not, to my knowledge, been put to any set of words, but it is such a majestic and beautiful melody. So I couldn't help but include it today. Before the service in Windsor yesterday, Luke Bond played this meditation on Psalm 34, verse 6 by Herbert Howells, another great British composer. He wrote six psalm meditations, the first three before World War I, and the second three in the middle of World War II. So this is the first of these, and arguably the most famous. I cried, and the Lord heard me and saved me from my troubles. And then moving from there, Sir Henry Walford Davies, who was master of the King's music in the time of George VI and also organist of the Temple Church, wrote this solemn melody in the wake of the death of Queen Victoria in 1901, originally for string orchestra, and he later arranged it for the organ. And then lastly, the first movement of Sir Edward's Majestic Sonata in G, Opus 28, an Allegro Maestoso. This was the postlude at yesterday morning's service at Westminster Abbey. Once again, thanks so much for being here and for being part of this wonderful occasion. I'm just going to scoot upstairs and play a fanfare to God Save the King, and then please join me in singing, and the rest of the concert will proceed from there. Thank you again for being here, and welcome.